Well, I'm here with David Richards, CBE, the chairman of Motorsport UK. It's great to have you here. You've just been on stage and done an amazing little talk, a Q&A, about motorsport as a whole and the environment that we're currently in politically.
Yeah, that's it was really talking about the engagement with government and the role of our body as a governing body and how we can influence government to assist us and develop motorsport in the UK and recognise it, more importantly.
Where are we currently at? Because motorsport is really at the forefront of technology and that drives change. So when it comes to the political environment, how hard is it to get engagement?
We've got to recognise we are a small minority sport. There are lots of other people out there shouting louder than us. And I would suggest that the last 10 years, we have taken a bit of a back seat. You know, motorsport has been a great technology driver over many, many years. You look back and think of all the things that have come out of the motor racing world, and we've had good recognition for that. But in the last decade, we've slipped behind. Technology from the industry has gone ahead, and we're now catching up. And until we take a lead again, I don't think we've got a lot to shout about, and that's one of the challenges we face.
And is that environmental challenges, or is that the way it's perceived as a sport?
I think it's both. It's clearly there are environmental challenges that we have to address, and we are doing that as a governing body already. But there's also the fact that sort of new technologies, we've got Formula E, we're going to introduce electric karting into the UK, we're going to introduce other alternative fuels, we're going to look at hydrogen as well in the longer term. So lots of technology we will be bringing, but we've got to get on and do that more quickly than we are at the moment.
And so for you coming to Autosport and being here and having this sort of talk in the environment we're currently in, because these chats have normally happened behind closed doors. It's great that people can come here and witness these sorts of conversations.
I think part of our problem as a governing body is, you have to have your license to go motor racing. A bit of a distressed purchase. People don't realise all the work that goes on behind the scenes, the planning that we've got for Brexit, for our members who travelling abroad to compete in Europe next year, for instance, the work that we're doing with education, the work that we're doing with disabled people, the work that we're doing with environmental lobby groups and things. All this goes on quietly behind the scenes, and that's what people pay their license fees for.
Absolutely. And what about gaming when it comes to the esports environment? This is a vastly growing part of the motorsport industry, and one that I think has been hard for the usual fan that goes to a circuit to get their head around.
No, the traditionalists, I'm sure, wonder what this is all about. But of course, the reality is younger people are sort of possibly not engaging with us as a pure sport in the normal terms that I would recognise, yet they're racing on PlayStations and things in their bedrooms and engaging in that way. We've got to embrace those people. We've got to have a far more engaging view of who our audience is and who our potential participants are in the future.
So the big question then to finish, where is motorsport sitting right now and where is it going to be in, say, 5 years?
The answer to that is we're at a pivotal point. We're at a point in time where we have to get out there and look to the future. We have to engage with new technologies to do those advances that they did 50 years ago in the sport. We've got to go out there and explain our role. We've got to not be apologetic for what we do, but tell people about the great things motorsport has been doing, the great achievements of motorsport across all sorts of platforms, and engage with all the touch points in society that we're able to do.
It's quite a challenge, isn't it?
It's a big challenge, but we're up for it.
David, thank you very much.
All right.